Today we're going to teach you about the four roots of anger, an easy way to help folks who might be having issues with impulsivity or reactivity after having a feeling of anger. We narrow it all down to four main emotions, and by narrowing it down, we're better able to establish a foundation for our anger. Chances are you react with anger due to the same fear or hurt or guilt or helplessness over and over. When we can pinpoint it, we can better understand the complexity of our anger and our emotions and choose our responses rather than reactions and react in ways that are healthier for our well-being. The first root is hurt. Hurt can come from two different kinds of pain, physical pain or emotional pain. Physical pain is probably more self-explanatory, right? You stub your toe when you're bringing in groceries and you're like, dang it, oh, that hurts, right? Maybe you get punched or kicked or slapped. Those are more overt ways of having hurt. But in essence, you react. Why did you hit me, you jerk, right? Rather than saying, ow, that hurt me, we're yelling, we're reacting and responding impulsively out of anger. Emotional pain is more covert, under the scenes, like behind the scenes, right? So maybe you're feeling bullied. Maybe you're feeling bullied at work or at school. Maybe people are disregarding your boundaries for time and asking you to take on too much. Maybe you're supposed to hang out with friends and they ditch out on you or you get ghosted. This can trigger feelings of abandonment, which all can lead to feelings of emotional hurt. Either way, understanding that it's hurt and responding with using words such as, I feel really hurt when you did that, tends to be more effective than responding with anger. The second root is called guilt. Guilt tends to be when we realize, hey, I did something wrong, but we're not humble enough to admit it in the moment. Maybe we feel like we have to be defensive about something and we're afraid of making mistakes. Either way, recognizing you made a mistake or you made a poor choice and not wanting to admit to that truth in the moment, that can lead us to reacting in anger. So my favorite example of this is if I come home and I wonder, did my spouse empty the dishwasher? I might say, hey, are these dishes clean or dirty? The correct response or the healthy response might be, oh, you know, I wanted to get to that, but I had a lot on my plate, or work was really hectic, or something happened, or the dog wouldn't go outside. All those things respond in a way that says, hey, I wanted to, and I feel bad that I wasn't able to. I can then respond to that saying, oh, let me help. If you respond or react out of guilt in an angry way, you might say, why do you always nag me about the dishwasher? Geez, can't you see I'm busy? When we respond in anger rather than admitting guilt, we tend to bring the level up into a defensive fighting mode, right? Doesn't get us anywhere, certainly not healthy. But a lot of times we tend to respond to things with anger when it's really a feeling of guilt. This next one is the one I use, helplessness or inadequacy. The first, helplessness, is feeling like you have no control over the situation, or you feel like there's no other options. Maybe it's you get angry because your boss says you have to work overtime with no more pay, or maybe you don't get to go do something fun that you want because you have a responsibility at home. You feel like you have no choice, that you are stuck in this moment. When we feel helpless, we can respond in anger by saying, oh, I never get to do this, or this always happens to me. When we start to realize ourselves using those words like never or always, we know we're feeling overwhelmed, right? So we can look back and say, wow, I feel really helpless in this situation. Rather than saying, you always stick me with these kids, you could say, I feel like I really need a break right now, and I don't feel like watching the kids is going to give me that break. Okay? Inadequacy is the other kind of portion of this root. Feeling like you're less than. Feeling like something is wrong with you. This tends to go back to our childhood messages where someone told us there's something wrong with us or wrong with our person, things that generally we can't change or that would be difficult to change. So maybe you feel like someone says, you know, you really did a terrible job on this project at work. Oh, I really worked hard on that. This is tough because I felt like I did a good job. Maybe someone says that you're boring or you're not fun anymore. And then you feel less than, like something is wrong, something that you can't change. It would be easy to respond in anger. You're a real jerk, you know that? Or, hey, there's something wrong with you. But again, that puts us on the defense. When we're defensive, we're engaging in fighting behaviors, even if it's verbal fighting behaviors. So if we can go back and we can establish this understanding, this is what I'm feeling. This is how I'm feeling. This is how I'm responding to that comment. Then we have something that we can work with that's on a healthy level. If we just respond with anger, we likely will get met with anger in return, not something that's healthy or helping us move forward. Sometimes we have to get it all out. I understand that. But when we can name the underlying emotion, we give everyone in the conversation a better opportunity to make healthy responses, productive responses. To sum things up, anger is not an emotion to be avoided, not at all. But as a former really angry person, I realize that understanding this root cause behind my anger was what I needed to help me really think through my emotion to say, am I just scared? When this person pulled out in front of me in traffic and I freaked out at them, was that because I was angry? Yes, but that's because I was scared for myself. Should I really have yelled at my boss, or should I have told my boss, it really hurt when you passed me over for the promotion? Should I have yelled when my roommate came home and asked why the dishes were still in the sink? Or should I have said, yeah, that was my bad. I should have done them, I just didn't get time to do so. And when I feel like less than, because maybe I am appearing less than perfect, or I've done something not to the best of my abilities, rather than getting angry, I need to just say, I just didn't feel my best today, or I just didn't do my best. When we can understand our own emotions and why we react and respond to them, we can better predict this and make better choices. I hope that learning the roots of anger helps you as much as it helped me in my journey towards peace and calm and understanding of who I am in all situations. Best of luck. If you have any questions, go ahead and type it in the comments below. I'm more than happy to help you.